Only essential activities for 15 days in Maharashtra starting 8 p.m. Wednesday. Prohibitory orders imposed in the entire state starting Wednesday. The chief minister says no lockdown yet, but situation is scary as cases are exploding dangerously. Gujarat COVID crisis worsens, crematoriums ablaze with pyres as deaths rise, lines of ambulances outside main city hospital. Is Madhya Pradesh covering up total deaths? The cremations at Bhopal crematorium, just one crematorium under the COVID protocol, is alone exceeding the official figures of the entire state. NDTV analyzes the numbers. Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee's dharna against poll panel in Kolkata. Meanwhile, there's huge roadshow by Amit Shah despite poll panel's COVID curbs. Mamata Banerjee addresses a rally soon after the ban ends, says we will not allow Bengal to become Gujarat. And festivals being celebrated across India amidst worst COVID crisis. Hello and welcome to NDTV 24/7. I'm Rohit Wellington. Let's begin with our top story. Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray on Tuesday stopped short of enforcing a lockdown but announced tough restrictions for the next 15 days that permits only essential activities in the state. From Wednesday, Section 144 or prohibitory orders will be imposed across Maharashtra and only essential travel and services will be allowed. The war has begun again, he said. And added that cases are exploding dangerously. The new measures came on a day Maharashtra reported over 60,000 daily cases. Mr. Thackeray also requested military's help in tackling oxygen and medicine shortage in the state.
कडक पावलं उचलण्याची आवश्यकता आणि ती वेळ टोकशण आलेला आहे. मग काय करायचं? मी एकदम काही लॉकडाऊन असं म्हणत नाहीये, पण काही निर्बंध हे साधारणतः त्या सदृश्य आहेत. कारण ही साखळी जर का तुटली नाही तर ही साखळी आपल्याला पूर्ण गुरफटून गुंबरून टाकल्याशिवाय राहणार नाही. आपल्याला रोजीरोटी महत्त्वाची आहेच, त्याहीबद्दल मी बोलणार आहे, पण रोजीरोटीच्या बरोबरीने आधी जीव वाचवायला पाहिजे. जीव वाचलं तर सगळं काही आहे, आणि जीव वाचवणं हाच आत्ता आपल्यासमोरचा महत्त्वाचा मुद्दा आहे. आणि तो वाचवण्यासाठी मी पुन्हा एकदा सगळ्यांना हात जोडून विनंती करतो आहे की आजपर्यंत जी काही निर्बंध आपण टाकलेले होते त्या निर्बंधात आता आपण अधिक वाढ करतो आहोत. आणि हे निर्बंध उद्या 8 वाजल्यापासून, संध्याकाळी 8 वाजल्यापासून आपल्या राज्यात लागू होतील. आणि त्याच्यासाठी मी माननीय पंतप्रधानांना काही विनंत्या करतो आहे. त्या बाकीच्या तर मी आपल्याकडे सांगतोच, पण एक विनंती मी त्यांना करतो आहे ज्याच्याबद्दल मी अधिकृत पत्र पण लिहितो आहे, की हे रस्त्याने आता ऑक्सिजन आणेपर्यंत आमच्याकडे फार विचित्र परिस्थिती निर्माण झालेली आहे. मला कल्पना नाही असं करता येणं शक्य आहे का. असेल तर आपल्याला लष्करी तज्ज्ञांची मदत घेऊन जर हवाई वाहतुकीने आमच्याकडे ऑक्सिजन आणू शकलो आपण आणि आणू शकत असू तर कृपा करून आम्हाला नुसती परवानगी नाही तर एअरफोर्सला सांगून आम्हाला मदत करायचे तसे आदेश द्या.
Several key announcements in the Chief Minister's, long sort of address to the state, where he actually mentions what all is going to be shut. The most important announcement perhaps is that Section 144, which is a prohibitory order which bans the gathering of people without a valid reason, is now in force across the state, at least comes into force from 8 p.m. on Wednesday. And this will of course happen by then. The cabinet meeting also would have taken place. But all these restrictions have been announced. The Chief Minister also announcing that the Shiv Bhojan Thali will be available free of cost, so that those who may not have the wherewithal to buy food could avail of the Shiv Bhojan Thali, which is available free of cost. Several other initiatives, payments to labour who are registered, and also the roadside stalls of Mumbai, those have been allowed to stay open because a lot of people depend on those stalls also for food. So let all of that is there. In fact, that is going to continue, and several other things as well. Public transport is going to continue, but there will be of course severe restrictions that will also come in. You cannot move around without a valid reason. and exemptions which are there, those also are of course there in writing in that order. And you know, medicine shops, grocery shops, all of those things which are essential services, banks, financial institutions, you know, data centers, all of those will of course have to continue working. But all in all, it's different from last year's lockdown. Several things that had hit people really hard, those things have been seem to have been addressed. But of course, once it comes into force from you know, sort of 8 p.m. on Wednesday, one will see the full impact on Thursday. So obviously all of these things will be enforced, but clearly you know, lockdown like restrictions but not a full lockdown. The break the chain is what the effort is, because Mumbai really and Maharashtra really is running out of facilities to treat COVID-19 patients in the second wave, which has hit the state hard. The state is of course ramping up capacity of beds. There's an oxygen shortage, several other drugs shortage. So all of those things are being addressed. In the meanwhile, the government hopes that these 15 days of less activity, which means less interactions, which means less spread of COVID-19, will help them ramp up the capacity that they need. And these restrictions will come into force from Wednesday 8 p.m. and they will continue for 15 days.
But what's the situation on the ground in Maharashtra? NDTV's Sohit Mishra has traveled over 1,100 kilometers in the state and is currently in Pune. He sent us this report from one of the worst hit districts in the second COVID wave.
Right now I'm in Pune's Hadapsar area. Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray few moments ago had said that from 14th of April at night 8 p.m. Section 144 will be imposed. There has been several rules that has been made. On my left hand side is a bus that is going to Latur, Maharashtra's Latur, and behind me are few of the laborers that used to work in Pune but are now scared, are feared that the lockdown would begin, and that's the reason that they have now once again started to migrate. However, this time they have started to go via these buses.
Khane ka bandobast nahi hota na lockdown hone ke baad, khane ka aur rehne ka
nahi ho raha,
ha isliye ja raha hu main Latur.
Acha, aapka naam batayega, aap kya karte?
मैं गाड़ी चलाता हूँ, संदीपान सुबेदार है मेरा।
गाड़ी मतलब क्या, कैब चलाते?
हाँ, कैब चलाता हूँ।
आप भी लातूर जा रहे हैं, क्यों जा रहे हैं, क्या हुआ? गाड़ियाँ तो शुरू हैं।
गाड़ी का वो धंधा नहीं हो पा रहा ना इधर, हाँ। इसकी वजह से लातूर जा रहा हूँ मैं।
अच्छा,
उधर तो अपने अभी रहना पड़ेगा एक दिन, जितने दिन लॉकडाउन चलता है उतने दिन तो रहना पड़ेगा ना।
काम लेकिन कैसा है, सेठ जो बोलता है कि तुम मेरे जिम्मेदारी के ऊपर तुम काम करो, हमारा जिम्मेदार नहीं है। कल अगर लॉकडाउन पड़ भी गया तो हमारा जिम्मेदारी नहीं है, तुम तुम्हारा देखो,
आपका देखो।
जस्ट आवर्स आफ्टर चीफ मिनिस्टर उद्धव ठाकरे अनाउंस दैट सेक्शन 144 विल बी इंपोज्ड, एंड व्हाट वी कैन सी इन पुणे हडपसर इज दैट पीपल बिलोंगिंग टू एटलीस्ट नागपुर हैव रीच्ड ओवर हियर, एंड दे से बिकॉज ऑफ द न्यू रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस हाउ इट इज इंपैक्टिंग देम, दे आर नाउ गोइंग बैक टू देयर विलेजेस। इन पुणे विद कैमरा पर्सन प्रवीण जी रोहित, सोहित मिश्रा, NDTV.
Now, as cases surge in the national capital, even crossing that of Mumbai at the moment, Delhi government has decided to scale up the health infrastructure in the city. One of the measures is that is to designate 14 private hospitals to treat COVID cases only. But what is to become of patients who've been hospitalized already due to other emergencies? Sukriti Divedi brings us this report.
Today's record high is the third consecutive day that Delhi recorded over 10,000 cases. It is also day one of 14 major private hospitals being co-opted by the government as COVID-dedicated hospitals. The non-COVID patients in these hospitals are now hassled. Veena Goel's 82-year-old mother, Saroj Gupta, a cardiac patient, has been admitted for 12 days. Today, she was told she is being discharged as the hospital is now only for COVID patients.
I wasn't really surprised when I read about it yesterday night in the news that 14 hospitals and this particular hospital, so we were really scared. But it was, I would say, thanks be to God that she is stable. And of course at home we have made some arrangements. We have a nurse and a dedicated room.
Others are less fortunate. 23-year-old Himanshu Gilodia came from 45 kilometers away just outside Delhi. for his hip replacement surgery scheduled today, but was turned back.
दिक्कत तो हुई आने जाने में, लेकिन अब क्या बताएं, अब जो डॉक्टर ही ऑपरेट नहीं करे तो क्या दिक्कत। उन्होंने अब पहले ही ये बोला था कि आज का डेट दिया था, देन फिर अब बोल रहे हैं कि जब तक, अब कल शाम को जैसे गाइडलाइन शुरू हुई है कि कोरोना के उससे अब क्या कहते हैं बाद में ही एडमिट करेंगे।
द दिल्ली चीफ मिनिस्टर मेड दिस अपील।
जो प्लान्ड सर्जरीज हैं अपनी, जैसे मान लीजिए किसी को नी रिप्लेसमेंट कराना है, किसी को ये महीना दो महीना तीन महीना डिले हो सकते हैं, जो इमरजेंसीज होंगी दिल्ली में उसके लिए अभी भी सफिशिएंट कैपेसिटी है अपने पास कोविड बीमारियों के लिए, कई सारे अस्पताल अभी भी हैं, लेकिन जो प्लान्ड सर्जरीज हैं वो ज़्यादा होती हैं, इमरजेंसीज कम होती हैं, वो अब हम थोड़ा सा डिले कर लें।
The numbers too reflect that it's the COVID patients that are in greater danger, with 91% of the ICU beds for COVID patients occupied, as compared to 74% for non-COVID patients.
With Delhi recording over 10,000 cases on a daily basis, COVID patients definitely need to be the priority. But the government will have to ensure that non-COVID patients do not become collateral damage in this process. In New Delhi with camera person Sushil Rathi, this is Sukirti Dwivedi for NDTV.
Now to Gujarat, where the COVID crisis is worsening. Crematoriums are ablaze with fires as deaths rise, and there's line of ambulances outside the main city hospital in Ahmedabad.
Ambulances with corona patients lined up outside Ahmedabad's main hospital for COVID care, the civil hospital. The facility clearly unable to cope with the rush of patients. Gujarat is among the worst affected states in the second wave of COVID. More than 6,000 new infections and 55 deaths were reported from the state on Monday. The main hospital for COVID, the Ahmedabad Civil Hospital, ran out of beds, and a long line of ambulances could be seen outside the hospital with COVID patients inside awaiting treatment. Medical help like oxygen had to be provided by paramedics to patients inside the waiting ambulances till the patients were accommodated.
टोटल अभी मेडिसिटी कैंपस में 2008 पेशेंट दाखिल है। टोटल कैपेसिटी 2120 की है। कल की रात की जो बात करूं मैं, तो हमारे यहां 108 जो एम्बुलेंस लाइन में थी वो सब पेशेंट को हमने पूरी रात लिया है। जितना भी पेशेंट आता है हम किसी को मना नहीं किया है, सब पेशेंट को हमने यहां 1200 बेड में लिया है।
एट क्रिमेटोरियम्स अ क्यू टू फाइंड अ पायर फ्री। इन दिस वीडियो फ्रॉम सूरत, बॉडीज बीइंग क्रिमेटेड आउट इन द ओपन एज क्रिमेटोरियम्स आर ओवरफ्लोइंग। Non-stop burning of bodies has also led to the melting of gas furnaces at three major crematoriums in Surat city. That Gujarat could well be approaching a health emergency of sorts were concerns expressed by the Gujarat High Court that will take up for hearing again on Thursday a suo motu PIL on the COVID situation in the state. The court had observed, why are remdesivir injections being sold at such a high price? If oxygen and beds are available, why do people need to stand in a queue? The court had asked. In the meantime, the impact of the epidemic. Shops closed in Rajkot, and amidst a surge in cases in Surat, crowds of migrant workers have begun thronging bus stands looking for a way to return home, fearing another lockdown. NDTV Bureau Report.
US regulators have recommended a pause on Johnson & Johnson's COVID vaccine. This after they say that there have been reports of rare and severe type of blood clot in 6 persons out of millions vaccinated. US CDC will be reviewing the cases pending which they have recommended a pause on the use of the vaccine. And after the pause in the US, J&J will be delaying vaccine rollout in Europe. The company has said that we are proactively delaying vaccine rollout in Europe. We are reviewing cases with European authorities. We are working with medical experts and health authorities, and beneficiaries reporting severe pain in head, abdomen or leg, or those facing shortness of breath must contact authorities. Back home, is Madhya Pradesh government concealing data of COVID deaths? In the second wave of the pandemic, the COVID-19 deaths surging. Crematoriums are overburdened, but there is a huge mismatch between the numbers arriving for cremation and the health bulletin by the state government. Anurag Dwari reports.
Scary pictures at the Bhadbhada crematorium in Bhopal. 84 में गैस कांड के पीड़ित के बाद दूसरा ये वक्त है जो हमको देखना पड़ रहा है। उस समय मैं 9th क्लास में था, 9th क्लास के बाद 50 साल की एज में आज पहली बार मुझे दूसरा मंजर ही देखने को मिल रहा है। अभी तक यहाँ 30 से 40 लाशें जो है जलाई जाती है, क्योंकि कोविड से रिलेटेड।
And now concerns are being raised on whether the state is actually reporting the correct death toll due to COVID. There were 37 COVID bodies at this single crematorium in Bhopal on Monday. The health bulletin for that day mentioned a total of 37 deaths in the entire state. Scenes at the crematorium, a clear mismatch with the COVID fatality figures from the state.
3-4 ghante se baithe hue hain. डेड बॉडी जो है कि हमारी वो रखी हुई है वहाँ पर, अब चारों तरफ जो है डेड बॉडियाँ जल रही हैं, वहाँ क्रियाक्रम करना तो कर ही नहीं सकते, इतनी जल्दी वेट करना पड़ रहा है। जितनी बॉडी है उसके हिसाब से यहाँ पे जगह नहीं है, आप खुद भी देखिए।
NDTV studied the fatality figures over a period of 5 days and found inconsistencies. Sample this. On the 8th of April, 41 bodies were cremated in Bhopal under the COVID-19 protocol, but the medical bulletin that day said that there were 27 deaths because of COVID in the entire state. On the 9th of April, 35 bodies were cremated in Bhopal, 23 as per the government bulletin in the entire state. Though the government maintains that no under-reporting is taking place.
सरकार की कोई मंशा नहीं है कि किसी भी तरह की मृत्यु के आंकड़े को छुपाया जाए और वो छुपा के किसी तरह का हमें कोई अवार्ड नहीं मिलने वाला, ऐसा कहीं भी कोई मंशा नहीं है।
Crematorium workers highlight their problems from running out of wood to blisters all over their hands.
100-150 कुंटल लकड़ी जा रही है डेली परमानेंटली।
अच्छा, रोज के कितने जल जाते हैं?
हाँ, एक रोज 40-45, 30-32 आज बाड़ी आ रही है डेली।
While Madhya Pradesh is battling a surge in COVID-19 cases and lockdown, the dead and the kin are crying for a decent cremation. In the second wave of pandemic, crematoriums are clearly flooded. But if you see the government bulletin, the administration is clearly fudging with the data. In Bhopal, with camera person Rizwan Khan, Anurag Bari for NDTV.
Welcome back. In Bengal, Mamata Banerjee, who faced a brief ban by the Election Commission for allegedly making provocative remarks, resumed campaigning and spared no time in hitting out at Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah. Speaking at a rally in Barasat, she warned, "If I am pushed, I can also push back."
Bangla ke Gujarat korte debo na, Bangla ke Gujarat kora jabe na. আর আমাকে আটকানোর চেষ্টা করে কোনো লাভ নেই, আমাকে প্রতিঘাত করলে আমি প্রতিঘাত করতে পারি, আমাকে আঘাত করলে আমি প্রত্যাঘাত করি, আমি ঘরে ঢুকে যাওয়ার লোক নই।
And finally, in Maharashtra, there were muted Gudi Padwa celebrations amid the pandemic. Here's a report.
The second time in a row, Gudi Padwa is celebrated amid the pandemic. Families normally visit their relatives and relatives come over, but this time around they are only resorting to home puja. And the colour on the street is also missing.
Corona ki wajah se bahar karna acha nahi hai, iske liye humne Gudi ki puja ghar mein hi kar di hai.
In Gurgaon, which is also where Mumbai's biggest procession for Gudi Padwa is celebrated, but for the last 2 years because of COVID, the procession is cancelled. There has been no public gatherings which have been allowed.
Is saal bhi hum log usi utsaah se, usi jallosh ke sath ye Hindu New Year manayenge, par apne apne ghar pe sab niyamon ka palan karke.
During Gudi Padwa, flowers of marigold are sold the most, but this year florists are complaining of no customers. With trains not functioning for normal public, retail florists are spending more money on taxis with no good return. Even the jewelers, which had to shut stores last Gudi Padwa and even this year, are saying they are losing business.
7-8,000 ka dhanda hota hai, magar is bar itna nahi hua, 2-3,000 ka hi hua.
लोग भी नहीं आ रहे,
लोग पब्लिक भी नहीं आ रही और माल भी नहीं मिल रहा।
किसी तरह लॉकडाउन नहीं करके अनिश्चित लॉकडाउन करें, जिससे कि एक शॉप खुली है तो दूसरी शॉप बंद रखे, और इस तरह से किसी न किसी का सॉल्यूशन करके लोगों को एक मौका दे कि लोग अपने घर में होने वाली शादियों में कुछ इसी तरह अपना हिस्सा लेकर जो सोने का हिस्सा है उसको परिपूर्ण कर सकते हैं।
With growing cases, Mumbai along with rest of the Maharashtra is celebrating the festival very subtly, aware and conscious of the pandemic. In Mumbai with camera person Rajendra Thayalkar, this is Purva Chitnis for NDTV.
That's a wrap on this bulletin from the entire team. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.